Hey guys, Pasty Boy here. Today we're going to be doing something that I've been meaning to do all season long, and you guys have been asking about it for a couple of years now. So let me show you what I'm talking about. All right, so here's the dirty sled, and now that the season's over, of course, this is the time I'm going to actually take to address this issue. But first, I want to talk about what the subject is today, and a lot of you guys have been asking about these little mirrors on my handguards. So, if you stay till the end of the video, I'd appreciate it, but I'm gonna put a link in the description and you could check it out on my Amazon page where you could get these little mirrors for your handguards. Now, you have to make sure that your handguards have these two little holes to mount them on or it won't work. These are not like the latest, you know, 2021 or whatever handguards. These are probably from maybe 2014, something like that. They're a little bit older style, so I don't know what the new ones have. But if you have ones with this setup here, with the two screws, these will work for you. And there'll be a link in the description where you can pick them up if you're interested. So my issue today is that a couple of years ago, Dennis, the guy that I bought these from, you'll see him in another video. I'll put a link at the end of the video to the ride he came along with us on. I think it was last season. And so when I got these from him, they already had the mirrors on them. And at the end of the season, before I put the cover on it, I would take the mirrors or the handguards off completely and then put the cover on. And primarily that was because these stick up higher than the handlebars. Well, last year I got lazy and I didn't do it and noticed it bent them down. It bent this one down and bent that one back. So what I'm gonna do today is take my heat gun and see if I can get them back to a good position, because they did me no good this whole season. I would have to like duck down and stuff like that just to see anything out of that one. This one was impossible at that angle. Now the cool thing about these mirrors, and I'll show you when I'm done, is that they rotate. They're not perfect circles. They're kind of oblong at one side and thinner at the other. Hope you can see that. And so that'll allow you to fine tune them to what angle you want to see behind you. So let's get to straighten these out now. So this is the heat gun I'll be using today. It's just the old cheapie from Harbor Freight. It was about 10 bucks. I've used it for a bunch of stuff and works pretty darn good. I don't use it all the time, but when I need it, it's there and it works. So I'm gonna start obviously with the throttle side one, and I'm gonna heat it up from both sides and see if I could just bend it back to something like that and get it to stay there. Now this has two settings. I'm gonna start with low. Seems to be softening it up. And I'm gonna shut it off for a second here and see what kind of angle we've got. Alright. So right now it's pretty low. So it really needs to be more like that. Not sure if it's gonna stay there once it cools. So currently where I have it, I can see behind me here, see my hand, and that's That's pretty good right there. I like that. I've got the mirror dialed in. Now, if you turn it counterclockwise, it kind of goes down and out, which about down here, which is no good. You don't want to see that. And then as you get it, the thinnest spot up top, that's pretty good. Can't really see my shoulder. So then that's a little low. That right there is pretty good. Just gonna bend it a little bit more so I can get it to hold in that position. And this year I'm definitely taking these off, or at least rotating them down now, because then it's still gonna get caught up here on the cover. So even though I keep it in the garage year round, I mean, when I'm not riding it, this thing's in my garage. I never leave it outside unless we're out riding somewhere and I have to leave it outside. Other than that, this is always in my garage. So it doesn't really need to be covered, but keeps, you know, dust off it all summer long. It keeps, you know, anything that might have gotten put down on it or knocked over on it off of it. So that's pretty good right there. And you can still fine tune a little bit with the dial. So I like the way that looks. Pretty good right there. So we'll move on to the other one and see if we can't get that dialed in. Now this one was obviously way down. Now it's in a good spot. We're gonna move over to the left-hand side one and see if we can't get that to a better angle. All right, before we move over and do the left-hand side one, I just wanna show you what I'm seeing from. Well, so this is my point of view. So if we aim to the mirror and zoom, let's see. So that's what I'll be seeing. That's a pretty good view, even though my garage is all messy. That's a pretty good view of what's in the shot. So it's a good spot to see behind you. All right, and this is the current view of that mirror. Would have showed you the other one before I moved it, but it was aiming down, so it was unviewable. But this one, you can see that it's no good. So that's like a full arm's length away, and my hand is barely in the picture. So what I was having to do was lean way over just to see something behind me. That's no good. So we're gonna fix that now. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get the mirror oriented symmetrically to the other one, because I already know that's the angle I want the mirror rotated to. I'll show you a side view of that mirror so you know what I'm talking about when I rotate it, how it changes the angle. But so looking at this one, I've kind of got it like right about there. So in this one I could see just about my right shoulder, like barely. So I'm going to try to get that one. See, right now it's completely out of view, so let's get some heat on that. Just applying the heat right at the bend on this mirror. A little high action here. Back down to low. All right, I'm gonna see if I could start moving it. Pretty soft. I'm kind of twisting it, as you can see. And my shoulder's getting in the shot here now. Now it does bend back a little bit.
a little low, I think.
This would have been awesome to do on a trail, obviously, or even in the street or something, so you could really see what's behind you. Unfortunately, you know, there's no plugs in the middle of the trail, so I'm stuck just looking behind me, but I figure if I could just barely see my shoulder, I can see my arm, it's pretty far out. It should be pretty good. Plus, that's pretty close to the natural bend and angle that the mirrors originally come in. So I think off the bat, they're a good setup. But I think I'm pretty happy with that. And the other thing too is you could lean a little bit when you're riding, but that's a pretty good view. Happy with that. I'll try to bend it just a little bit more. Yeah. So what I can see here is just the end of the grip at the bottom of the mirror. Well, the lower right portion of this mirror and the end of this grip and the lower left portion of this mirror. So I know they're even, and then you can always dial them in a little bit more if you needed to. But I'm happy with that. So let me show you what I'm talking about with the way these mirrors rotate, and they have different angle so that you can change your perspective on each side of the, on each mirror. So if you're just looking straight on, you can't see any difference. But when you look from the side here, it's a lot thicker and then it gets thinner. So as you turn it, it changes the perspective. And I found that this view is best for what I want to see. So as you can see, seeing a little bit of the grip in that shot, and you can see pretty good behind me here. Same with the other side. So you can see a little bit of the grip and beside and behind me. And I'll just give you a straight down view so you can see what kind of angle those mirrors are at. Obviously, if you purchase these, they'll be at a good angle. I mean, they were when I first got them. But as far as what angle I've rotated the mirror at, you can see I've got them set the same on both sides. And so that should be ready for next season. Should have did this a long time ago with all the downtime we had all season, but I was pretty busy doing other stuff. So that's that. But like I said, if you're interested in a set of these mirrors and you have guards that have the mounting holes for them, check the link in the description. Okay, to ensure that you get the right product, go to the Amazon link below. That's my Amazon affiliate page. And go to the snowmobile gear tab. And in there, I'll have three or four different sets of mirrors, depending on what guards you have, that will work. So also, if you don't have guards at all, I do have a few different ones in there that would fit your sled, potentially, if you have a skidoo. That's mostly what I have in there, but there's a lot of accessories to check out anyhow. But just make sure you get the right ones, because nothing's worse than ordering something, you get it, and it's not the right one. So take a little look down there and see if you find the right thing. All right, guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're interested in purchasing some of these handguard mirrors, check the link in the description at my Amazon affiliate page. And check the other links in the description. like me, Pasty Boy, on Facebook and Instagram. And too bad the season's over, but we'll be back this spring and summer with some other content. And of course, back next winter with more riding videos. So thanks again, and we'll see you next time. Take care. Arrgh!